Welcome to Chicago's Cousins Traveling. Subscribe so you can come and see the world with us. It is travel day, and we are waiting for our driver to take us to the airport for 7 days in Cabo San Lucas, and one of my favorite resorts, and I just can't wait for all of the greatness that's about to happen in 7 days. So waiting on our driver, and then we're on our way to the airport. Talk to y'all soon. Finally at O'Hare Airport, and it is crowded. These 6:30 a.m. flights be killing me. Like, I literally only had 2 hours of sleep. So today is gonna be just a really chill day. I'm not gonna do too much because it's travel day. And I'm not a big fan of travel day. Let me show you guys O'Hare Airport. And O'Hare Airport had the air sky high.
At the American Airlines counter. And we board in like 30 minutes.
One of the things I love when I'm flying is to look out at us flying over water. I love flying over water. So I am a window seater, but I like aisle seats too. It depends, but I mostly do like the window seat. And the good thing about going to Cabo is you do turn around over the water, so you get to get that pretty view. One thing I do, Cabo to me is like a mixture of Vegas and the Caribbean, because you have the deserts, you have the cactus, you have the mountains, but you also have the ocean and the water. So to me, it's just like a combination of the two together. It's a party city, very beautiful. So this is one of my favorite cities in Mexico and why I'm excited. So we are here waiting at the Cabo Airport for our car service. We have a private car service. And look at my mom with her Cubs shirt on. Everybody want this shirt. They was asking you about it. And so you definitely want to make sure you get some sort of car service, because they are going to charge you with taxis and bum guard you with taxis. So definitely set you up some sort of private car service. All right, and here is our driver here. So the good thing about being a Hall of Famer, you are gonna get private transportation to and from back to the airport. So we're passing the terminal now, driving to Hard Rock Los Cabos. It's about a 45 minute to an hour drive, usually no traffic. And this is a gated community. You're gonna go through two security gates. We just went through the first one. And then once you go through those gates, you are on the Hard Rock property where there's Nobu. They're building Unico, and they have these amazing villas. Like a whole community of villas that you can stay in, and they are beautiful. So the good thing about Cabo, there's so much land, there's so much to do for them to build and make the city even better. But look at those villas. Those are all villas. And there you can see that they're building other properties right next door to Hard Rock. They are building a Unico, which is coming. So we have now arrived at the Hard Rock Hotel, and you're gonna go through that second security to just make sure who you are, which is why I love resorts, because there's much security on these resorts, trust me. So that's the good thing about staying at resorts. You are protected for the most part. And this is a very beautiful property. So we are excited for the 7 days ahead. This is my mom's favorite property as well. So perfect for her birthday. She loved the people here. And I'm excited to visit for the second time. And keep in mind, Hard Rock has these quotes all around from famous people, which are some pretty great quotes. And so we are now going into the lobby. And this changes colors. So you can see the gold now. Very beautiful display. This is where regular guests will check in. So when you do come in, you get to see your brief shops. You got that ocean view immediately, letting you know you are here in Mexico by the beach. And all of the shops are right here. You also have a sunlight bar. But what I love about being a member of Hard Rock, and now that we are Hall of Famers, we do not have to go through the regular checkout. I have heard stories that the regular checkout can be pretty lengthy, 30 minutes to an hour at times. You can see people standing in line there, checking in or checking out. So when you are a legendary member, there are two other ways to check in. Regular legendary members have their own private check-in, and since we are Hall of Famers, we got upgraded to check in a more sophisticated setting where we pretty much just go sit down, sign, and we get ready to go to our room. It's really quick and easy. Here is one of the rock shops where you can get the Hard Rock gear, and we have our person here that's going to take us to where legendary Hall of Fame members check in. So definitely keep this in mind when you are looking to get a membership. You get so many perks depending on your membership level. Whether you're a regular legendary or if you're a Hall of Famer, you get different membership perks. And what I love most about this is guitars are everywhere. You know, guitars is the Hard Rock logo, and they have some very beautiful ones. Like, oh my God, so nice. So there is the concierge. There's where you go to get take care of everything you need to take care of. They hooked me up for my mom's birthday surprises that I have set up. And here is the legendary check-in. So as you can see, we get a little buffet of food. You don't get none of this at regular check-in. Not even the legendary member check-in do you get this.
I just noticed that.
They have like a little guitar donut station. They'll get you your drinks.
Your own drink when you come in for Hall of Fame members. This is really nice. Don't have to wait in that check-in line.
And I mean, we was literally probably in there 10 minutes. So here is the birthday packages, and you can email ahead of time and they'll email you this package. You can pay ahead of time. You can combine all of these, or you can get one, whatever, choose whichever you want. But you can contact him. He'll be glad to help you with any other birthday setup. This was a great week for us to go to Cabo. This is usually their rain season. And as you can see, it's clear in the 80s all week. So when we first get there, you know me, I'm going to take a look at that view. And they gave us the exact same room we had last time because they figured, look, they like that room. Let's give them the same room. But we actually did want something different. So, but I'm not complaining. This is a blessing. So they did. I had them set up.
She got so hungry. She bit into it before I could take a picture.
Yeah, I had them set up some strawberries for her. And she just bit it before I could even take any picture. Here is the other view from the balcony. This is the side where you can see the resort, a partial ocean view. Look at that sun. Those beams. It's just beautiful. You can also see the main pool from here. And at night when a hard rock light up, you can see that. So I like that this room does give you two different views. And now that we've unpacked, we are on our way to dinner.
Dinner at Zen's.
Yeah, so now I had to put a banner on my mom's door for her birthday, and she has on her Michael Jackson gear because we are going to the Michael Jackson show, and I have something special set up for her there. That's where you will go for the shows. Now we are just walking along, going to Zen, and look at all these amazing guitars from the celebrities. They're probably replicas. I don't know if they're the actual celebrity guitars. I doubt it. I think they are probably replicas, but you never know. But there's some really nice ones in there. and even like memorabilia, clothes of the celebrities, the photos. It's just really nice how they have it set up. Jimi Hendrix and everybody. It's like some of everybody. So Zen is the Asian restaurant. And as I indicated, you can do hibachi bar, you can do a la carte, and they fill up. So you definitely want to make all of your dinner reservations right away. If you're a Hall of Fame or legendary member, you can do it in advance. If you're not, I think you can only do it daily. And these spots fill up quickly. It's a very, very nice, romantic, intimate setting to me at this restaurant. I love the art on the wall. And on vacation is about the only time I will eat seafood, pretty much.
So we are currently gonna eat dinner here at Zen, which is the Japanese restaurant. I'm not a big seafood eater, but when I'm on vacation, I will eat some sushi, some salmon, which is very rare for me because I typically don't eat that on a daily basis, but I'm gonna try it today. Hopefully it's good. This is the view. And I'm just waiting. My mom went to the bar. They do have a teppanyaki bar as well, but we do that all the time, so we wanted to do a la carte. Let you guys see how the food looks when it comes.
So I don't know what that was I ordered. It looked like tuna tartare or something. It was pretty good.
Spring rolls.
The spring rolls were good. And then I ordered a sesame seed crusted salmon filet, which was good. No complaints.
This is one of the bars, the Sunlight Bar. And it has an outdoor too.
So now we're waiting for the Michael Jackson show.
Watch my drink while over there.
And as you can see, the colors have changed. It's now purple in the evening, which is my favorite color. So you know I love this intimate setting here. And they also have a bullet room where you can go play pool and a few other games that they got in there. They probably have video games as well. So it's really, really nice. And I like that they have multiple pool tables, so you don't have to worry about not getting a table. I don't know if it have a cost. I actually haven't played pool here, so I don't know if you have to pay or not. And me and my mom just looking cute, having drinks. I love her MJ wear. We are both huge Michael Jackson fans. Huge, huge. Like huge, huge Michael Jackson fans. And look, Michael Jackson came. He saw her in her outfit. She's gonna act shy now. But that is a really, really cool picture. And the entertainment crew was really, really nice.
Okay, I'm going up here and get our seat. You get some coffee. Oh, it's right there. Grab two bags, Mom. How do you get? He said we're Hall of Fame. We go up front. Yeah, we are Hall of Fame.
We just got some. Yes,
okay.
Hello, we're aquí. Leonor, are you here? Leonor, desde Chile. ¿Estás por aquí? No? Okay. Mia, how are you doing? ¿Cómo estás? ¿Todo bien? Excelente. Guys, please, let's big applause because he's Mr. Bruno!
My mom was shy at first. She thought they were going to pull her on stage. I said, I don't think they're going to do that. But I was glad that they had that to honor her for her favorite show. So Hard Rock will accommodate you. Just got to find the right package. Now, every Hard Rock have Michael Jackson impersonator. And this guy, he really actually can sing really, really well. As far as dance, I love the one at Riviera Maya the best. He has Michael's dance down pat to me more, a little bit more smoother. But both guys are amazing. I just love the performance. I'm happy to see impersonators keeping Michael Jackson legend alive because he's the greatest. Like, come on. I just love it. So I will always go to the Michael Jackson show because it's just always exciting and it's something new and you just never know what to expect. But the Riviera Maya one, still my favorite. And I like that they had the Thriller cast come from the crowd, the audience. But me and my mom never can get enough of Michael Jackson. I mean, she watches his videos all the time on YouTube. And then she also has some DVDs of Michael Jackson. So he lives forever in our hearts.
We are doing a fly dress photo shoot tomorrow. And not tomorrow, the day after tomorrow. And this dress is so long. Now the room comes with these steamers, which is great for this dress. But look at how long it is. And it just keeps going, going, going. It's gonna take me forever to get this completely wrinkle free. I did some.
It was a challenge.
But I don't know, I might take this to housekeeping or something, but very long dress. I can't wait for this photo shoot. Stay tuned. Chicago's Cousins Travel. Good morning from Los Cabos. So today is gonna be our full day on the resort and I can't wait to get to the pool. Now remember, most beaches in Cabo, you cannot swim because it's really like 100-foot drop, like 10, maybe 10 feet into the water, and the waves be so strong that they would just carry you in and pull you under, and not to mention all of the sharks that are in the Pacific Ocean. So you cannot swim here, but you can go down and walk along shore. Just be safe because that water will pull you in. I don't care how good of a swimmer you think you are. It is just not safe.
That is true.
But they do have places that you can go. Some resorts have made beaches that you can swim in. So you can look for those places. Like we're going to Taboo this week and you can get in the ocean at Taboo. So definitely look to see where you want to go if you do choose to swim in the ocean. But today is just gonna be a chill day on the beach. I missed the sunrise this morning because I was super lit last night. All right, I'll check back with you all later.
Look at the moon.
So good morning, today is day two. Our first full day here at the resort at Hard Rock Los Cabos. And I surprised my mother with a beautiful birthday breakfast. I'll show you guys the footage of that. Last night we had a really great time. It was hectic travel day, of course, but today we're gonna go to the pool after we have our meet and greet breakfast, being Hall of Famers here. We're gonna renew our package to get some better deals, especially since some new hotels are coming up. So we're gonna go and do that. But look at this view. So beautiful, so peaceful. So I'm gonna try to blog as much as I can for you all today. Tomorrow we have our fly dress photo shoot, so I'm sure that's gonna be great.
So this is the birthday surprise breakfast for my mom. They gave us mimosas, fruit, eggs,
And we ended up eating two breakfast and then brunch, because we had our legendary member meeting, and they take you to breakfast. So when on vacation, calories don't count. Yeah, you're supposed to eat.
But you can order also a la carte.
And enjoy.
Which they have a really good menu. But I have to get my pineapples because I'm a pineapple freak. I love fresh fruit, but pineapples are my favorite. Watermelon. And they have this for dinner too. Nice little dinner area. Then they got your yogurts. This isn't the actual breakfast buffet. This, you do order a la carte here, but the dinner here is what's really amazing. So I want you guys to see what they have for dinner here. This is really nice. It's a beautiful restaurant here at Empanemas.
And so we sat with our representative, ate breakfast, just briefly went over things we wanted. And then she takes us to the legendary member lounge. And here's where we're gonna meet my mother's favorite person, Indigo.
So this is the legendary room. This is where they're gonna take you on a tour. This is the property at Hard Rock Punta Cana. Look at that map. This is the largest Hard Rock there is. But this is where they take you so you can become a legendary member. As you see, can see, I am a Hall of Famer. And so that's like top tier. But this is where you will go in this beautiful space. And you'll meet the agents, and they will dedicate packages perfectly for you and your family and your vacation experience.
Hi, this is Shana A from Chicago's Cousins Traveling, and I am going to give you the room tour of the presidential two-bedroom suite here at Hard Rock Hotel Los Cabos. Our room number is 4239.
When you first come in, as you can see, you have your dining room table that fits six people. You also have your bidet area, like your sink. You have your refrigerator down here that's filled with all the drinks that you need during your stay. And remember, Hard Rock Los Cabos is not that old. It's only about 4 years, and you hear the wind closing the door there, but it's only about 4 years. So this hotel is practically new, very beautiful, and that is a sofa bed for the living room, so big enough to fit your family. And then we're gonna go into the master. And as you can see, it's my mom's birthday, and I just decorated her bed. I bought my own decorations to decorate her bed. And she has that beautiful ocean view as well. TV, plenty of drawer space, area for your desk, king size bed. And then it does look out to the tub, the Japanese soaking tub. As you come here, your closet space. And then you also have your vanity here. Nice closet space. You get those steam irons. And then the two vanity bathroom. Then your shower, which is a rain shower and handheld shower. And then in here is the toilet. I love the pictures that they have on the wall. Then when you come out to her balcony, you see you have the chairs, you have a tub there, a beautiful oceanfront view, and then it does lead. Also, six dining room outside table, and this balcony connects with the living room. Another big TV here. And then you also have more closet space. So very good on the closet space here. You know, if you have somebody that's gonna be sleeping on the couch, those are my mom's fly dress. I think I got a video of my fly dress because we're doing a photo shoot.
and then you get another iron. Then you have another half bath here where you have the, just, it's not a dual vanity, but just another sink. Big mirror there. Another rain shower with a bench. And then here, the toilet. So plenty of bathrooms if you have a big family. And then here is my section. And as you can see, you have another entry to come in. So you have two entries. You have your bench for your, for you to put your suitcases. You also have another refrigerator there, wet bar, and a bench here. And that door keeps slamming from the wind. And then you do have your TV that can turn, so you can move it because you can watch it while you're in the tub. Have your long bench here, as well as the table. And in this side, you get two beds, two queens, so double beds. And then the bathroom comes with this huge jacuzzi tub that I love, which is why I love being on this side as well. And then a rain shower, handheld shower, much bigger in here. And then your toilet. And then your dual vanities here. Blow dryer scale, comes with everything you need. And then you have more closet space in here. And there's my purple fly dress. We bought our own flying dress, but some photo shoots come with it. But we decided to buy our own. You also get a safe and drawers here. So a lot of cabinet space in this room, in this two bedroom presidential. And then remember, these doors close all the way up into the wall. You can keep pushing. You also got your outside jacuzzi here. And then you got a different side of the hotel view. Still an ocean view on this side as well. The pool view, the Hard Rock sign, and all of the fun that's here at the Hard Rock. So this is the two bedroom presidential suite here at Hard Rock Hotel Los Cabos. Make sure you like, subscribe, hit that bell. Thank you for watching. I am going to show you more of our 7-day vacation here celebrating my mom's birthday. Thank you for watching. Potato. And they sell like sandwiches, pastries, sweet treats, easy, quick to grab, all of your coffee, everything you need here, juice.
This is a really nice,
you can
shop.
Sit here and enjoy it. And they also have gelato ice cream too. And then here's the vacation planners where you can go to book all your excursions. And they have a new Awaken Your Senses experience. It's not all inclusive. It's $175 a person, 20 people per three dinners they do daily. So very limited. It was almost booked. They made an exception for us. And now we're headed to the legendary pool. And being Hall of Famers, we got Bali beds every day, which is cool. They also have a different pool menu over here versus the menu at the main pool. This one is much better. So if you are legendary members, definitely come to the legendary pool and take advantage. And the weather was just beautiful. It was a bit windy, but it was hot, very hot actually, and just a very clear day to be there rainy season. The water looks beautiful. And I'm about to have some drinks and some lunch and sit back and wait while we sign our contracts, because we did do an upgrade with Indigo and we had to wait for our contracts to get printed up. So the pool was the perfect place to begin. As you can see, I'm looking good. And now I'm headed into the pool. I already got my Bob Marley. The water was perfect, especially for the heat. It wasn't super, super cold water, but it was refreshing. Every time I drink on vacation, I always get hoarse. I don't know what it is. It's something about that liquor, that yak yak. It's just not for me, which is why I love weed, that ooh wee, ooh wee. I may be singing off key, but I really can sing, ooh wee. That liquor's just not for me, ooh wee. I do that all day. I just play around making up stuff, singing. But I'm just taking in all of this. This is my favorite pool, the infinity pool. It overlooks the ocean. It's never packed with a lot of people, you know, so it's just the best pool on the resort out of about 7 of them that they have. They got pools that we never even go to on this resort, which is great because you can't get into the ocean. You know, you gotta have those pools, and all of their pools have a great view. So it's like you really don't need to be on the beach at all, to be honest with you, because the way that they have their pool set up here is amazing. It's a beautiful view, and it makes you feel like you're on the beach regardless, you know. And I just love blue bottom pools. I love to see that the water is clean. I love to see if anything's in the water. I'm very, very picky about things like that. So I did not like the black bottom pool too much at Unico, but I love this pool and I love the view. And the good thing is they say cruise ships actually pass by there, so you can catch that. And as you can see, I'm doing my spin. I got my Bob Marley. And I'm just enjoying myself. And my mom doing her floating. She loves to come float in the water. And it just feels so good. This is when you know, okay, here we are. Here's the birthday girl. And we are just feeling ourselves. Like I said, they have tacos, burritos, salads, you know, they got it all. Fruit.
Hey guys, so guess what? Craziest thing happened. We ended up upgrading our contract because, you know, we are legendary members. And we were saying how we wish we had the swim up. So our representative, Indigo, is amazing. I absolutely love him. My mom loves him. She adores him. So if you are looking for a legendary membership here at Hard Rock Los Cabos, I recommend you speak with Indigo. He's going to hook you up, man, with the best packages for your vacation needs. So we were mentioning how we wanted a swim up, and he just accommodated it. It wasn't offered in a package or anything. He just took care of us. He's so great. So we had to hurry up in 20 minutes and get out of our room and pack after we unpacked. Now, I don't know about y'all, but we unpacked, okay? So we had to hurry up, unpack in 20 minutes, and our room will be ready at 5. So we're back at the pool, and I will show you guys the new.
So there is the amazing Indigo, the guy who takes care of everything for us. And he really spoiled us on this trip, especially for my mom's birthday.
All right. Here
with
you go.
The upgrade, and also dinner at Muna at Nobu. He gave us an amazing credit for her birthday. And now we're going to Empanema's for dinner after having that long day at the pool and having to pack and then go back to unpack. It was a lot to do really, really quickly, but we're very grateful and thankful. And I'll show you the room tour of the swim up, but now we're about to have dinner.
and Panema bring all different types of meat to your table. They do have appetizers here that you can try. This is like their desserts. Wow, look at this tart, Mom. Oh, I know that's good. Cheeses, vegetables. Potatoes, some sort of oyster dish, broccoli and veggies and cauliflower, pork mussels, some fish. And they have the hot grill here.
Hola.
Hola. Yes. Those beans are the bomb. I have to have them
rice and
every
peas.
Time I come.
Oh yes, rice and peas right there. And there's some soups here. And of course your salads. So in Panema, it is the spot. If you come to Hard Rock Los Cabos or any of the Hard Rocks, they have in Panema there.
As you can see, I loaded up on some of everything to try.
All right, so this is steak empanada with cheese.
Oh, wow.
And we have Serrano gravy and chimichurri. Only this one, the green one, Serrano. This is spicy, all right?
You mind if I record? Oh, great. Thank you so much.
He was a great waiter. Right.
Do you like the spicy?
I like the cheese, yeah. Thank you. Well, that's it. Yeah. Give me the chicken and bacon.
And they just keep bringing all these meats.
Give me like, the chicken and bacon,
come
too.
Really, really hungry here at this hotel, at this restaurant. You have to be hungry because you're going to want to try everything because it's all good. That roasted pineapple, oh my God.
I am going to do it.
Oh, and look at that music symbol.
You're right. There it is. That's nice. Since we are Hall of Fame members now, at the Hard Rock Hotel permanently, we have this little booklet that they gave us. Came with a charger. And it tells us like everything we're getting as far as amenities and things.
I thought this was a pretty cool gift to give. So you can always remember everything that comes with being a Hall of Famer, because it's a lot. Well worth it. And as I indicated, the prices vary. It's up to your vacation preference and needs. There's different upgrades, so the prices vary and it can be affordable for you.
You can see. Pretty cool. So you'll never forget your amenities because they gave it to you in this booklet. Pretty cool.
And so now this is the next day and it is my mother's actual birthday and we started off with our fly dress photo shoot. It's like 6:30, 7 a.m. in the morning. We had to come early because it will be too hot if you don't. It was a hike. We had to go down this hill, then go down some more stairs. I mean, it was a lot, as you can see, but worth it. You know, my mom really wanted to do this for her birthday. I will show the photos later.
Today is my mother's birthday, and we just did our fly dress photo shoot, which was a lot. It was a lot of walking in the sand, but beautiful, beautiful pictures. I can't wait to see them when they come back, but yeah, day three is already starting off exciting. I need to rest now, eat some breakfast. We went to take the photos at 6:30 this morning because you don't want to be out there when it is too hot. So that was the perfect time. And now we're back, it's about 9:30 and we're gonna head to breakfast, probably take a nap. Because let me tell you, walking in sand with a long dress is no joke. Okay, so we're gonna take a nap and then head to the pool and then my mother's birthday dinner tonight. So excited about today.
peace.
And so there you see some of the pictures. Some of my pictures I'm not showing until later, so I'm just giving you a brief view. My mother already shared hers all over Facebook because she's so frantic.
Hi, this is Shana A from Chicago's Cousins Traveling, and I am going to show you the two-bedroom presidential oceanfront swim-up here at Hard Rock Los Cabos, which is our room we changed to. So take a look. Okay, so there's two ways to come into our room. You can come in from 4142 or here, 4143. And this is the main entrance, 4143. And it's my mom's birthday, so I had them set up decorations with her birthday package. As soon as you come in, you're gonna see the full length mirror with a nice stand here. And then you're also going to come in and you'll see a half bathroom with the shower there, one sink. And then of course you have your dining room table here.
There was snacks, but we ate them.
The living area. You also have your wet bar. So of course, your sink, coffee machine. You have your refrigerator down here with all of your drinks in there. And then this sofa is a pull, it's a sofa bed, so it does pull out as a sofa bed. And then we have the oceanfront view, which is a swim up. We have the chairs out here, full swim up tub, and we're overlooking the rhythm pool here. Have a fire pit, and then this side over here connects to my room. So beautiful, beautiful swim up. It's semi-private. It's only people who can really see you are the people who will probably be at that swim up. But semi-private swim up. Pool's all yours when you stay in this room. And so when we come back through the living room, I'll show you my side first. Oh, this wind closes this door. But you have another full body mirror here. That's the door, the other door that you can come through. You have your closet space here with your safe and some drawers. So very spacious. You have another cabinet, another refrigerator down there for your drinks, coffee machine. And then this room has two queen beds, a couch, TV, the long desk with drawers, and then the bathroom. You have the two vanities, mirrors. Then of course your toilet is there, and then your rain shower. So a little bit different from the regular two bedroom that I had the big jacuzzi, had the big bedroom and the big jacuzzi. So you sacrifice that so you can get that view and that swim up. So I didn't mind giving that up to have the swim up and the oceanfront view. And you know, you can go right out here too to get outside. And there's also another tub here.
It is adult only, I found out.
And there's that rhythm pool right down there, which is more of a quiet laid back pool. And that beautiful oceanfront view, a sofa here. So different from the other two bedroom presidential that's not the swim up. That one is more spacious, but this one is a sacrifice, give and take. If you want that swim up and that ocean front, you're gonna have to give up something. One of the things I did miss is that there is a big closet there as well. So if you do have someone in the living room or you run out of closet space, a lot of closet space there. So now walking into the master, have a couch there, your king size bed, your TV, your long desk and chair here,
And then, of course, your swim up. That view, and then another tub there. So very, very beautiful room. I like that they're all aligned across each room. You have your Japanese soaking tub here. Then there is your closet space for the master. You also have your full body mirror. A lot of storage space. You get 2-3 steamers in this room, which is great. Soaking tub. And then you have your vanity mirrors here. And your shower. And your toilet.
And this is the presidential.
So very, very nice. 2-bedroom, oceanfront, swim up, which are new here at Hard Rock Los Cabos. Make sure you like, subscribe, hit that bell, and continue watching the rest of our Los Cabos Mother Birthday vlog. Thank you.
Or no, actually we're on our way to the pool. Because today is my mother's birthday, and we met some really nice people yesterday at the pool who, it's an interracial couple, Charlene and Brian, really cool. His birthday is also today, and so they offered for us to come to their cabana, which was really nice. They didn't have to do that. And so these are the actual cabanas. They have a bed, they have a bathroom, private bathroom, couches, loungers. Okay, and if you got a large family, the cabana is perfect for you. So now I'm just at the main pool, taking in the view. There's Shaitan. Best butler in the world. For my mom, she don't know, like I've had them do a birthday show shout out, I've had them set up decorations, she got champagne coming to the room. What else have I done? We have her birthday dinner tonight, and they're gonna bring a cake and do this whole amazing birthday celebration for her. And then tomorrow we have some amazing things tomorrow, so I can't wait for day 4. But day 3 is starting off great, which today is actually my mother's birthday. So really, really enjoying it so far. Here at the pool, they're doing movie and trivia, and
I'm
we're
sorry,
just
y'all.
Chilling
I love
and enjoying
you.
The weather.
I love
it's so beautiful
women.
Here.
I'm just not gonna conform to what society to say we should be, and I'm definitely not gonna starve, but I am gonna work out more. But I love my fitness, and I am enjoying me, loving me, happy and free. So we went back to the room to enjoy the swim up, because of course we got upgraded, why not enjoy it? And I had them bring champagne. Shaitan, our butler, brought it for us.
Nothing.
And
but
also one, another gift. She got a Hard Rock pin.
Glasses.
Yeah. Let me get your pin on this. Put it on this video. I'll show them your pin. Show the pin.
I'll put it on my dress later.
Okay.
And so I'm in
cute.
That sweater.
I mean, it's cute.
Yeah.
And then in a day, I can drink like almost 3 drinks.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
Yeah.
This is like heaven for real. I love having my own private pool to come in here and just chill. You know, you guys, I got this swimsuit from Shein. I had on a yellow swimsuit last time I was in Cabo.
That is no joke in Cabo.
I really liked it, so I decided let's go for yellow with
hot. I'm kind of OCD, I think. I'm very, very germaphobe. And my mother always talking about people peeing in the pool, so. And I'm just enjoying myself, getting a tan. As you can see, I'm already getting darker.
And make sure you check out my books. Remember, I am an author slash poet, poetess, and I have 3 books out, but here is my collection. Make sure you check out both my books, Purple Flames, Inferno of Poetry, and Watering Flames, the novel and the poetry. It's a story between the lines of poetry, available now. You can go to my website, www.lesbianeroticpoetry.net.
And so they moved the birthday, decorations to the table, which is great because she had to sleep in her bed. So that was the perfect spot.
So tonight is my mother's birthday dinner at Toro the Steakhouse. I have another surprise set up for her there. I've been surprising her with something every day since she's been here.
And one of the best things about this hotel is all of the great exhibits, like the photos, just the details of whoever designed this did an amazing job. It's just a very beautiful hotel. And this is one of my favorite exhibits, that yellow motorcycle. It's nice. So we're waiting at Toro, and now we're going in for her birthday dinner. And they staked, I have never had any issues with the steakhouse. It always top tier, top of the line. And again, the servers are always so nice, so pleasant. They truly treat you like royalty, and having that black wristband bumps it up even more. And look at the diva. You know, y'all, my mama a trip. She a Libra. Them Libras a trip. But you gotta love her. And look at this.
Thank you.
That bone marrow was everything. Sorry, vegans, but this is a steakhouse. Don't watch, but
it's good.
We enjoyed it. It's great to see her happy. So again, the way that they designed this, I love seeing that. The letters all on the counter there. I didn't take the time to read everything it said, but some of it I did. So we are now at the fire show, which is done right outside on the rooftop. And this was amazing. That was really cool, like Hot Wheels. This guy was amazing as well. Very entertaining show. If you go to the Hard Rock Hotels, catch that fire show. We always missed it because we were always busy doing things, but this time I made it. I made sure we caught the fire show, and we truly enjoyed it. And this part right here
is amazing. Like I said, this woman did her thing. Great show. And then we did meet up with Charlene and Brian for their birthday. Took some pictures. And then they did have the Elvis show. We didn't go to the Elvis show this time. She was trying to dance with me later, but we went back to the room. I got the fire pit going tonight. You can see it's so beautiful. Getting rid of the mosquitoes and about to give my Sophia Smokes hookah on.
Hey, so today has been a very, very long day for day three, my mother's birthday. Look, we've been up since 5 a.m. We did the photo shoot, then we went to breakfast, then we went to a friend's cabana. Then we chilled in the swim up. We maybe rest for about an hour. And then we had to get ready for my mother's birthday dinner at the steakhouse. And that was amazing. Then we went to this amazing fire show. So now I'm back in the room and I'm just chilling and vibing, smoking my hookah and survive the ocean, everything. You can hear the waves crashing. I'm feeling good. I'm loving day three and some great things still to come throughout this week.
So ladies, a lot of ladies have asked me, what do I do when I'm on my period? Because I travel a lot. Thing is I don't be on my period when I travel, honey. There are ways to manipulate your period. And I asked my doctor, and my doctor recommended birth control pills. And she told me how you can manipulate the birth control pills. You can make it skip weeks, so that way you can manipulate it to come at another time. And that's what I do, because I'm not about to be out here bleeding in no heat on my period. And it ain't even about having sex, because I'm single and I'm celibate. But I just don't want to be on my period while on vacation. What woman does? So talk to your doctor. She'll tell you the best birth control pills and tell you how to take them so you can manipulate your period. So that's my travel tip for the women. Get you some birth control pills. I am never, never on my period when I travel. I've manipulated it so many times whenever my period was supposed to come. Travel tip one.
So as I told you guys, Mexico made laws where they cannot provide hookahs to guests on resorts. So nightclubs, yes, but not resorts. So with that being said, everybody that knows me know I always bring my own portable hookah, and I prefer Sophia Smokes. I've tried every other hookah provider. Sophia Smokes is the best. Go on, give me that shout out, Sophia. And this is the Sophia Smokes. I've had it now for 2 years, and this boy is still smoking. This hookah has traveled everywhere with me.
So now this is day
pretty
four.
Much, but I got the fire pit lit. It looks
night.
Good. You can hear the ocean.
Relaxed, talked on the phone, and then crashed. I went to sleep. Like I said, that liquor hits me hard. But beautiful, another beautiful day. And today we are also going to chill at the pool. And we are going to awake your senses tonight. Awaken Your Senses tonight. I kept getting the name wrong, but I got it now, which is an amazing experience. But for the most part, for the day, we're just going to relax and chill and just take in this beautiful weather here in Los Cabos.
This is the room service breakfast. We got pancakes, some sort of Danish, eggs.
And my mom there in the swim up.
Breakfast burrito. Expand.
It got a little bit cloudy, but again, the weather was great.
So this is our Bali bed today. I like this one because it's right here by the water. We got our own private entry into the pool.
And they do
here
have
at the
live
legendary
entertainment. And he pool was a pretty good singer as well. So just another check that out. Day. Make sure you look at the event planner to see when there's going to be entertainment at the pools. And that salad was the bomb. I had to get one. Yeah, potato wedges with cheese. My mom got the legendary burger. And we had on our little matching swimsuits here.
I'm super lit. Like, we had all kinds of shots at the pool today. Met some great people. And that's the whole great thing about vacation, is meeting people you probably normally wouldn't meet anywhere else. So now I'm back in the swim up, as you can see. And tonight we have the Awake the Senses restaurant reservation. Totally new experience. It's supposed to be virtual reality. The room and the table changes to every dish, cuisine, country. So it's going to be pretty cool. I can't wait to see that. I will shoot some footage of that tomorrow, day five. We got Taboo and the Tropical Jazz Sunset Cruise, so that's going to be too nice. So, you know, these 7 days go quick. I can't do 3 and 4 day vacations too much no more, unless I'm going to somewhere like Vegas, Miami, something in the state.
Take pictures with the greats, Prince and Michael J, as we went to Awaken Your Senses. Again, you have to be on time. It's limited to 20 people per dinner. There's 3 dinners a day, 5, 7, and 9. And it's everything is designed on course with timing. So make sure you are on time. And there it is. At first, nobody was there, so we didn't know if that was the door we're supposed to go to or not. This is our first time. Remember, this is new, and this is our first time going here. But then someone came out, so we end up turning back and going back. So super excited about this experience. I saw the videos and it is amazing. Once you come in, you're going to be greeted with a special drinks. Now listen, they're going to get you drunk here. These drinks are powerful. You get a drink with every course. They're delicious, but very, 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 very strong. This one I like the most, probably one of the most out of all of them. But as you wait for all of the guests to come, they showed you the video of what you're going to experience. And it is just something I've never seen before. I will do this over and over again. They need these everywhere. It's truly amazing. The technology and just the experience, and the food was the best food I ever ate at a restaurant. Everything was great. But here we go. We are walking into the room, and they have your names everywhere for everyone to sit where they're supposed to. Pretty cool. And the chairs spin all the way around, so that way you can get footage. They actually want you to record. They want you to vlog this, so this can get, you know, people can learn what this is about. So they really, really encourage you to take pictures and videos. And the fact that you could just spin around and get everything is pretty cool. So now we're on a plane and we're going to our first city, which I believe is London. And they give you champagne for the first course. I love the music playing, it's very sensual. And there they gave you like some tuna and some caviar, and it was really, really tasty. Oh, purple clouds, now you know I love this.
the diver mode. That's so cool. That's so funny.
We caught that on tape, right?
Look at that shark. Oh, wow. This is so cool. Wow. Oh, ripples.
Thank you.
restaurant.
Oh. bigger.
I can't wait to go back next year to do it over again. So I went to the shop to get some cold medicine because I started to really feel that it was coming.
The Bajon Market. Got everything you need in here.
I got you. What's your name?
So we had to stop by concierge.
Oh, nice. Okay.
And then went back to the room.
Now this is how I like my pizza. Cooked. I don't like no undone, dough uncooked pizza. Cooked pizza.
Hi, guys. Today is day 5 and I am dragging. I am hungover. Last night we went to Awaken Your Senses dining experience, which is a virtual reality dining experience taking you across the country into every culture cuisine that they display for that dining experience. It was a drink with every course, 7 courses, 7 drinks, and the drinks were powerful. You hear me? I'm not a drinker, but I wanted to take in the full experience and I am lit still. It was, the food was amazing, top tier. The whole experience was beautiful. So I am going to show you guys the footage. If you're ever here in Hard Rock Los Cabos, the $175 per person is worth it. Go to the Awake the Experience, this Awake the Senses dining experience. It wakes every sensory in your body. Trust me. I want to give a special shout out to the Hard Rock staff. Our butler, Shaitan, you are amazing. Like, words can't even express how you took care of me and my mother. I see why she loves you. We have to have you every time we're here, Shaitan. Thank you for taking care of all of our needs, especially helping me with the daily surprises for my mom's birthday. Thank you so much. I truly appreciate you and all your hard work and dedication. Also, Indigo, thank you so much. I see why my mom also loves you as well. Thank you for taking care of our vacation needs and hooking us up with this beautiful oceanfront swim up. You didn't have to do that. Thank you so much for just taking care of us. My mom loves you. I love you now. So thank you. We appreciate you and everyone at the Hard Rock staff. Thank you so much for being great and making our vacation experience
wonderful.
So now we are
at Taboo.
2 more days to go and I'm still
and
excited
about
the 2 days left.
It was about a 30 minute drive, maybe 25 minute drive from the Hard Rock, and you can actually see the cruise ships right from this hotel that is, I think it's called the Me Hotel, which is attached to Taboo, and it's a beautiful view. We had did Taboo Tulum and now we're excited about Taboo Los Cabos. We heard some great things. And I just love the fact that they can still have hookahs.
We're at
now
Hard
they
Rock,
do
actually.
Do day and night parties.
Chicago.
You know, it was just me and my mom, so we just went to the day party because we already had plans for tonight.
Taboo Los Cabos. Super nice.
So we are here at Taboo Los Cabos. And this is super nice. I can't wait to get my hookah on.
Absolutely love their pool.
Look at this view.
So the great thing about Taboo Los Cabos, you ain't gonna have to worry about no seaweed. So that's the good thing. And you can come to their beach. It is a swimmable beach. Really nice. Oh, this is nice. Look at all the cruise ships.
And they said during turtle season, you get to see all the turtles' eggs hatch and they go into the ocean. It's really, really nice to see. So make sure you check the season. I forgot what he told me. I think he said somewhere around March, between March. It's about the same time as the whale seasons.
I love this. So you can swim here at Taboo Los Cabos.
So beautiful.
This is my space here, the beach. So let's see if it's a beautiful beach.
Even better. And this sand is perfect. Very clean. So I'm about to go smoke on the hookah.
That's amaretto sour. Should have the foam at the top.
Chilling in the pool.
And the Taboo staff was also amazing. They was treating us like royalty. I'm right. Like, wow.
Gotta do my spin.
This feels good.
So have you enjoyed your birthday?
This feels good to everybody. You know, people wanted you to have a great experience.
You
have it,
guys. Here
and a good vacation. That helps.
Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm. This is the apple.
This is so good.
Apple, I can't do nothing but an apple.
I'm done. You can take that. Yeah.
Cabos was great. I loved it. I like it better than Taboo Tulum. Sorry guys, but the pool is bigger. I like the beach, no seaweed. It has a more sophisticated, intimate setting. So I loved it. I really enjoyed it. We smoked the hookah, had drinks, food. It was just great. The staff was amazing. So now we are off to the Sunset Cruise, the Tropical Jazz Cruise. It's a little bit different than the luxury sail. So I'm interested in going on a sail in the evening versus in the morning, and then also to see the sunset and listen to some jazz. Pretty sexy. So I will give you guys some footage on that.
So the good thing about the Sunset Cruise is that you leave at about 4:10 p.m. to head to the port. And I haven't did an evening cruise. Mostly all of the sailings,
hard rock gear.
Sailings I do are in the day, but we wanted to stop and get shirts,
and they do have sales like 20%
because they had
off
a 20%
right
off sale that day. And the ride, I think it was probably about a good 30 minute ride to go to the port. It really wasn't a lot of people in the van with us, but you do get, you know, a van that picks you up and bring you back. And the Los Cabos port has almost everything there. They have shops, Senior Frog. They also have like a lot of restaurants, pharmacies, especially since cruise ships, you know, the people off cruises come to that port. They pretty much made it where it's kind of like a mall area. So you can have lunch, dinner, whatever you want to do there. They also have excursion places for you to book other excursions and boating rides, all in this strip mall, pretty much at the port. And so we had already got our excursions paid for with the hotel. We were just waiting to go to our boat. Now, there are different sunset sailings. You have to make sure you pick what's best for you. We wanted something just smooth and laid back jazz since it was just me and my mother, but they do have like a more of a hip hop type of cruise where they're gonna play hip hop music, more of a party boat. They have those as well. So you can just check to see which type of excursion that you want. And we are now walking to the yacht. There's going to be a lot of vendors out there, and they will even use their kids to try to get you to buy. So just a warning, they are going to hound you a bit there. And this cruise does come with unlimited drinks and food, you know, like a buffet of like fruit, meats, vegetables. So you do get pretty much a snack while you're on this sunset sailing. The water today was very, very choppy. Choppiness, I actually took a nap.
It is good.
A 20-minute nap because
figured you couldn't go wrong with no rosé.
Up and down, and it was kind of so relaxing. So, and we had a long day after drinking and chilling at Taboo. I was like, this nap is everything. But I just love this view of Los Cabos at the port, looking at the houses up on the hill. Also seeing the sea lions, of course, and they're just laid back. Little baby one up there. So cool. Next time we come back to Cabo, I hope it's during whale season, because I do want to see some whales again. So we have to plan and remember whale season is December through March. And you can even see it from your hotel, depending on what hotels you pick. And I thought that was like interesting, all those birds flying around in a circle over this rock. I wonder why, what they're doing. And some more sea lions there. That's their home. Very, very choppy water today. And it was cloudy, so we really, really didn't get to see a good sunset. But, I mean, it's amazing anyway. You're away from home, you're on vacation, you're sailing along the Pacific, or the Sea of Cortez. And listening to the beautiful jazz, they play some really good jazz that I haven't heard in a while. And we did get to see a peak of the sun starting to come down. Overall, this was an amazing cruise. I would do it again. It is day 6. I mean, I tell you, vacation week goes so damn fast. But yesterday we went to Taboo and we did a sunset cruise, which was really nice. It was cloudy, so we really didn't get a good sunset, but it still was really, really nice. Today is the foam beach party at 3. So we pretty much just chilling in a room right now. We ordered room service. And then we're going to head down to the pool. And then I think our dinner tonight is at Las Galas, which is my favorite Mexican restaurant. So it's very calm and peaceful. It was raining just a little bit ago, but you can feel the heat already kicking in. I'm gonna probably enjoy this swim up before I go down to the pool. Today I caught a brief cold. And I've been doctoring that all night, taking cough syrup and trying to sweat it out, turning the air off.
having your hair wet and getting in and out of pool, going from air conditioning to the heat, it will do it to you. So that's what practically happened. And don't forget, guys, to check out my newest book, Watering Flames. It is available. You can go to my website, www.lesbianeroticpoetry.net, and you can find the links to all three of my books, Passions of Love, Purple Flames, Inferno of Poetry, and my newest book, Watering Flames. So check that out. Thank you again for rocking with Shana A, Chicago's Cousins Traveling, Lesbian Erotic Poetry. I will keep you guys updated on today's festivities.
Got my mug set. I got my blue bubble
this
bath, as you can see.
Right,
my favorite.
For real.
And my hookah started, and I'm about to take a bath before I hit the pool. And I'm always feeling myself. Why not? And I did want to show you guys the other pools that we seem to neglect because we're always at our favorite. But over here is the Eden pool and a red pool. They also have hot tubs and another smaller pool. Mostly families come over here on this side, but they have Bali beds where you can just lay everywhere. I heard they also have a juice bar over here. I didn't stop by the juice bar, but I did hear some great things about it on other people's vlogs. So you may want to definitely check that out, especially if you do decide to come on this side to come to the pool over here. So you never really have to worry about being in a crowded pool if you don't want to. The main pool is usually the crowded, but if you don't like a crowd, you can come over here. Here's the red pool. The red pool is not really deep. It's just pretty much for you just to stand in or lay back in. But yeah, it's never a lot of people over here at the Eden pool, which is also another big pool with a great view as well. So if you ever feel like the other pools, or if you can't get into the legendary pool, if you're not a member, you can come over here. And you also have that rhythm pool, which is the adult only pool. And that's where I'm taking you now, to the rhythm pool. And now I'm gonna take you to the adult only rhythm pool. Is the pool that overlooks where our room is, and this section is adult only. Our room is right there, and this is a really nice vibe over here. As you can see, really laid back right here. And of course they have the slides right here that you can go down. And then this is the main pool where the parties be at. They're having a foam party tonight.
And the great thing about the main pool, like I said, they have, that's where the entertainment is. They're gonna have dancers, they're gonna have trivia games. They do also do the aquatics, if you do the yoga and all that stuff, they do that here in the pool. Just look at the schedule to find out what is all happening at the main pool. But I like the crew at the main pool. They're definitely going to keep you entertained. The only thing is this pool gets very crowded. So I'm not a big fan of being in a pool with a lot of people. It's just something that's not right. I don't like it. Especially my mother making me think to not like it even more. I already told you guys what she said. So I'm just enjoying it, waiting on the foam party to start. My mom was acting too bougie today. She didn't get in the water today. But it was a cloudy day today. It wasn't a lot of sun, so that may be why. Like I said, the crew is amazing. They're always gonna do something to make you laugh, and they love to see you recording.
Yes. Yes, I love it. Yes.
Also in the main pool, you are going to find more kids over here on this side. So keep that in mind. But I thought it was so cool because I seen so many people with floaties for their baby. And I was like, wow, the things they have for kids now is just so amazing. So the foam party is about to start. That phone gets everywhere. It takes over and everybody's just screaming. Guys on those stilts, like, I don't see how they do that. That is true talent, walking on those stilts, and they do it so comfortably and for a long time. So like I said, they have different entertainment. They had a saxophone player out there playing along with the music. It was just a whole vibe. So every Friday, from what I can see, every Friday is the foam party. So if you're coming on a Friday, 3 o'clock, you better make sure you be out there. I advise you to get your seats early because people were coming at 3 and those seats were already long taken.
So this room, you can see the sunset right from your room. It is just so beautiful. I've been trying to catch it and I kept missing it because this is the time we get ready for dinner. But look at that. Just amazing.
This is when my cold really started to act up, like I was really starting to feel it. So now we are walking to Los Galas, the Mexican restaurant. We've never been, well, I haven't been to the Mexican restaurant in the evening. I usually go to their lunch menu, so I'm excited to see how this dinner menu is going to be. I hope it is great. But just a night view showing you how to get to Los Galas. Los Galas is right by the main pool. So it's outside, but it has indoor, but it's just outside building near the main pool. And they do have a beach store now. So if you need like lotion or snacks or anything, even medicine, you can go right to that beach store. It's open during the day when the pool is open. And here we are walking in Los Galas.
Thank you.
Gracias.
That's okay, thank you.
The appetizers look pretty cool. But I do not like the main courses. I ordered two just to be sure.
So tonight we went to Los Galas, the Mexican restaurant. And here's a tip. The lunch menu and the dinner menu
are two completely different menus, and you will probably be highly upset with the dinner menu. And I'm just going to be honest with you. The lunch menu is the bomb. It has all the tacos, shrimp, steak, everything you probably would look forward to in Mexican cuisine, especially if you're from America. Great menu. But the dinner menu is what they consider to be fine cuisine. And sometimes when you do too much, you do too much and it's not good. And I did not enjoy that dinner menu at all. So I'm probably going to just order some room service, because when you are a Hall of Fame, we get a different menu than the normal menu. So we got some great things on there. So I think I'm just going to order from the dinner menu. But overall, I don't know if this is day 5 or day 6, to be honest with you. I think it's day 6 because we got one more day tomorrow night. This has been a very, very amazing vacation. It just goes too fast. Like, I wish the work week can go as fast as the vacation. Seriously, it seemed like we just literally got here. But, and this is one of the reasons why I can't do 3-4 vacations out of the country. Like, I can't do those anymore. It has to be at least a week or you can keep it. But yeah, so I'm just gonna chill in the room. I did catch a brief cold because I've been wetting my hair so it can curl, and having the air conditioning on, then getting in and out of the pool with the heat into the air conditioning. And I do have a slight cold. I went and bought some cough syrup, so I'm hoping that it calms down to get me back home. But I'm probably gonna be super sick when I get back home, because I'm gonna get in the pool again tomorrow. I don't care, I got in the pool today. Today was the foam party, and even though it wasn't a lot of sunlight today, it was kind of a cloudy day, I still got in there. But I could feel the cold starting to bother me, so I didn't stay in too long. But overall, I mean, this has been a very relaxing vacation with my mom. She enjoyed her birthday. Tomorrow, what we're probably gonna do is chill in the swim up. I know we're gonna go eat dinner at this Mediterranean restaurant at Nobu. Nobu is Hard Rock sister hotel, so we do get the opportunity to go over there. And I got a lot of great reviews about this restaurant, so I'm hoping it's good. And in Los Gales, like I said, is very, very good cuisine. I actually love their lunch menu, but I did not know the dinner menu changed. The dinner menu is completely different from what I was used to. So if you're looking for tacos, enchiladas, you know, tortillas, all of those type of things, you're gonna have to go to the lunch. The dinner has none of that. The dinner has all of these fine cuisine Mexican recipes I've never heard of. And to be honest, I didn't like the sauce. I just didn't care for it at all. And I tried two different things. I think I tried the enchilada something, and then a shrimp tamale that just wasn't good. So just keep that in mind. It may be different from you, but I prefer the lunch menu. So tomorrow I think I'm gonna walk to the beach, do a beach walk in the morning, take a few pictures, then head to breakfast. And like I said, we're just gonna chill in the swim up, go to dinner, then start packing. The part I hate the most is packing to come back home. I hate packing coming, but I really, really hate it to go back home. So that's just wanted to give you guys a little update on this vacation. It was a lot that we did, from going to some wonderful restaurant experiences to Taboo to the Sunset Cruise, just in the shows. It was just amazing. I tried to capture as much as I could, but then again, sometimes you just get too caught up in the moment. So I did do a little more recording this vlog than I normally do. So good night. I'm gonna give me some rest and try to calm this cold down so I can enjoy my last day tomorrow. Peace.
So it is a hurricane south from here. And as you can see, it is starting to rain a little bit here for our last day. And I think for the next couple of days, it's gonna be raining. So we had a great week. Kind of happy that this happening when we leaving. But look how dark it is out there. No sun whatsoever.
but still warm. So I may get out and swim up a little later, see the rain coming down.
And then you do get to get a trolley that will take you to Muna over to Nobu, which is next door from the Hard Rock, the sister hotel. And Muna is not all inclusive. It is quite pricey, but Indigo gave my mother a $500 credit for us for her birthday, and he set up a little birthday celebration for her. So that was super, super nice. And we couldn't eat that much. Like $500 was a lot, but I see why he gave $500, because the prices are high.
Once you're on the sixth floor to your right, and you will find
and they will get you a trolley back to Hard Rock.
Correct. You could just stop here and just ask the whether they would like a golf cart to pick you up here. Are you coming from Hard Rock?
Yes. So yes. Muna is a Mediterranean restaurant. So a lot of Greek food.
Oh, great. Thank you.
And it's very, very nice, sophisticated. And Nobu smells good, just like Unico. Mm-hmm.
Smells just
like Unico. Mm-hmm.
Different
scent, but
smells good.
So we were a little bit early for our dinner, but the good thing is that they have a Zen bar area, a bar room, and you can go in the bar room and have a few drinks. And you can wait for your table to be ready. They'll come and get you.
Our bar is outside. We have a rooftop. However, due to the weather for today, we are a little bit in a nice situation. We're private room. Is that enough?
Okay.
So this is their Zen bar. It's a private bar room. You can reserve these like for if you want a private session for your family to come into, you can do that. Let me tell you, that margarita was strong. The drinks at this resort were strong. If you think they're watered down, no, especially not in a restaurant.
Okay.
These drinks are nowhere near watered down. Like, they're powerful. And I love that you can see them cooking. So this is all open kitchen. It has glass, of course. Some of them have on mask. The pastry was great. And I ordered gyro. Whether you say gyro, I say gyro.
The bread looks good.
And then Indigo had it set up for her to have like a birthday dessert, and he sung happy birthday. Really, really nice. My mother definitely got spoiled this week, and she was super, super grateful for everything. You could see the happiness on her face. And that dessert was good. So we did took the trolley back. The trolley was waiting for us. And now it's time to go back and pack. And this is the part that I absolutely hate, is the packing part. But, you know, you can't be mad. You just had 7 days off from work, 7 days of fun. And just keep in mind, if you do want to go to Nobu, if you are staying at the Hard Rock, you do have access to go to Nobu. They have a really, really big pool there, but they can get the trolley to take you back and forth. It's not a far drive at all. So this is our final day. And overall, this vacation was a 10. I mean, I never have any complaints here at Los Cabos, Hard Rock anyway, but everything was amazing.
Thank you for watching Chicago's Cousins Traveling. Feel free to subscribe, like, and comment. Thank you.